right, now let's go back. You say that Emmy Lou looked as though something terrible had happened to her. Did she say anything?
Well, when she came...
She didn't say a thing. I told you before, she went into the bedroom and didn't say a word.
I suppose you didn't hear her say anything either.
Well, you see, I was kind of tired and I wasn't paying much attention
to her. Why don't you all stop stalling? You know you heard every word she said.
I said we didn't hear a thing. Not a thing.
I suppose you girls realize that Emmy Lou is the key witness to this whole business. Now, you know as well as I do who murdered Betty. For years, we've waited for Vanning to make one false move, and this is it. And... Oh, what's the use? I thought they were your friends.
So did I.
All right, if they're not, I don't have to handle the kid gloves any longer. Now, let's understand each other. I've given you all a chance to come over on the right side, and you've turned it down. Now, when I get Vanning, which I will, I'm going to get everybody connected with him. And that means all of you. You knew the deceased, Betty Strauber?
Yes, sir.
Will you please speak a little louder so the jury can hear you?
Yes, sir.
What kind of a girl would you say she was?
She was the sweetest kid you ever saw.
And up until very recently, she didn't know the kind of work you and her sister were doing?
No, sir. She thought we were models in a dress shop. Mary kept her in a swell school. Wanted her to grow up to be a good kid and...
Objection. As irrelevant and cheap pathos in an attempt to play on the sympathies of the jury.
I merely offer it in rebuttal to the cheap insinuations cast upon the character of the deceased Betty Strauber.
Overruled. Proceed.